Welcome to Maze Engineers, Maze Basics, the Fear Conditioning Chamber. The apparatus consists of a chamber with an electrifiable grid floor, a sound source, and a calibrated shock generator. The fear conditioning chamber is a behavioral task widely used in neuroscience to assess associative learning in rodents. Associative learning is the process by which an organism learns to anticipate events by creating an association between two stimuli. The major brain areas shown to be involved include the amygdala, hippocampus, frontal cortex, and cingulate cortex. Fear conditioning is a specific form of associative learning that pairs an unpleasant, unconditioned stimuli to a neutral, conditioned stimulus. After the animal associates the two stimuli, it will react to the neutral conditioned stimulus alone in the same way as if it were reacting to the unconditioned stimulus. Take, for example, a foot shock. Rodents naturally find this unpleasant and will react by freezing. Since rodents are naturally averted to this, the foot shock is considered an unconditioned stimulus. Now, say the foot shock was delivered at the same time as a neutral auditory cue. The animal will learn that the auditory cue is associated with the foot shock and respond to the auditory cue alone by freezing. The auditory cue is the conditioned stimulus. If the rodent has associated the two stimuli, it will respond to the auditory cue alone by freezing. There are different types of conditioning that can be assessed through the fear conditioning test. They include contextual fear conditioning, cued, delay fear conditioning, trace fear conditioning, backward trace conditioning. Contextual fear conditioning. Contextual fear conditioning occurs when an animal placed in a new environment is presented with an aversive stimulus and then is removed from that environment. If the animal has learned the association between the environment and the aversive stimulus, the animal will freeze upon returning to the same environment. Cued or delay fear conditioning. Cued or delay fear conditioning takes place when the aversive unconditioned stimulus is presented at the end or immediately after the conditioned stimulus instead of at the same time. Trace fear conditioning. In trace fear conditioning, there is a time interval, a trace, between the conditioned stimulus and the aversive unconditioned stimulus. As the trace increases, the association becomes more difficult to learn. This test is more complex and requires additional brain regions in order to establish the response. Backward trace conditioning. Backward trace conditioning can be used as a control test to establish that the freezing response is not arbitrary and is actually occurring due to the learned association. Here, the conditioned stimulus is presented after the unpleasant unconditioned stimulus. If the animal does not freeze in response to the tone alone, it suggests that the freezing which occurs in the experimental group is not arbitrary and instead is due to associative learning. The fear conditioning chamber allows us to test the effects of lesions of certain brain areas on learning. Typically, animals with lesions will spend less time freezing in response to the conditioned stimulus compared to control animals because they are less capable of associating the two stimuli. We can also use the fear conditioning chamber to test the effects of drugs and interventions that may improve associative learning, as shown by an increase in freezing behavior. The main limitation of the fear conditioning chamber is its sensitivity to a stressful environment of handling. But as long as external stress factors are minimized, the limitation can be overcome. The fear conditioning chamber is an effective and extensively used apparatus to test associative learning due to its variety of types of fear conditioning with different degrees of complexity. It is a valuable model for testing the effects of brain injuries or pathologies in brain areas associated with learning as well as potential treatments. MazeEngineers.com